Hello, my dear students. This is Professor Chetan Daga along with Dr. Santosh C. So we are on for the last module of this course, that is interview skills. We have already discussed four modules. One on communication skills, one on GD skills, one on presentation skills. So this will be the last module of the communication course, that is interview skills. So this will be, we will be having 2 days of videos today and tomorrow. So welcome you all for this course. So interview skills, we need to know what is an interview first. A meeting of minimum two expert candidate, one an interviewer, another an interviewee. So the person who takes the interview is an interviewer. So what is tested there? The subject knowledge is tested there, the skills are tested there, the desired behavior is tested in very short and limited time. So that is an interview. Now what happens in an interview is must. So before that, let's discuss which are the types of interview. There is a panel interview. Three or more experts sit across table from the candidate. So panel interview, there will be a panel of people, maybe two people, more, two or more than two persons or three even, consisting of a panel, and three or more experts sit across the table from the candidate and they take the interview. So that will be called as a panel interview. And face-to-face interview, one interviewer, one candidate. When there is only one interviewer and one candidate taking the giving the interview, and one interviewer taking the interview, is face-to-face interview. So these are the two types of interviews. So interview may be informal in nature. The face-to-face interview can be less distance between interviewer and candidate. It is less stressful and relaxed environment compared to panel interview. As it is a face-to-face, only two people involved, one interviewer and one candidate, it gets to be less stressful and the environment be relaxed. But in a panel interview, there will be more than three experts, so that may give some stress to the this candidate. Fine. So what are the things you have to keep in mind prior to the interview? So first thing is your CV. Now when you have prepared your CV, because you are going to interview, it shows that you have already prepared your CV, and in the previous one model we have already discussed about how to prepare a resume and a CV. So that is, if you have missed it, so you can just look around that video and even the notes which we have provided on our browser, on our website, guru-cools.com. So what CV you have given to the interviewer, you have to just first have a glance of it. Read your CV very keenly and properly, what you have given. Then what you have to do, to which company you are going for the interview, know the company. You have to know each and everything about the company. And what are the things you have to know, we will discuss in the next slide. Go to the company website, read the annual reports, read about the company on the business newspapers, magazines. So this is the thing you have to do. So directly contact the employees. So know the company. What are the things you have to know in the company? What are the services or the production things? If you are going to a manufacturing, then it should be a production. If you are going to a service company, it should be a service. So the service company, if you say like it is in a banking, so it gives services. So you need to know what the company is producing or what types of services are given by the company. Then what are the annual sales, what are the profits, what are the dividend given by the company, who are the competitors for the company, in which area it operates. Area of operation, I mean not the place of operation, it's the industry of operation. Is it a pharma company, is it an automobile industry, is it a banking sector, sectors of the company and area of operation. And what are the services or new products launched by the company. So these are the things what you have to know about the company. So before you go to the interview to any company, these are the things you should know and keep in mind about the company. Okay. So during an interview, employers evaluate. What the employers evaluate? They see the three things very importantly. One is your confidence. your skills of interpersonal communication and what your honesty. So you should be confident while appearing for an interview. This is the utmost thing. If you tremble while speaking, if you get confused while speaking, if you know everything, even though if you have lack of confidence, you are losing the job. So remember, the employers always evaluates your confidence. So he sees how confident you are in your so your confidence directly depicts your decision making skills. So that is what the employer sees in you. Then interpersonal skills, your fluency in English, the language, as it is the one of the important language, a corporate language, you can say. Then listen attentively. You should listen attentively, answer to the questions asked by the interviewer very fluently and very calmly. And you should not be in a dilemma, and you should do not speak anything if you do not know the answer. Just you can give up different answer, like you do not give a different answer which is not related to the question, sorry. Just you can tell, I'm sorry, I'm not aware of it. So that is more than enough, but do not round and round turn around the questions and answer your answers. So interpersonal skills are very important. That has been even checked or evaluated by the employers. You should be honest while answering in the interview. Even if you don't know the answer of a certain question, be honest in the answer to the interview. That's what I told you. So while answering in the interview, you should be honest, because if a question is asked and you are giving an answer which you do not know, and you are giving an answer which is not related, that shows that you are very dishonest. So be honest. Say, if you are not knowing, you can say, I'm sorry sir, I'm not aware of the thing. So that is what you have to keep in mind. The non-verbal or body language, what's your body language? Already we have discussed in the non-verbal communication part that how your body language be, how your posture be, how should be your gestures. So already we have discussed over there. Just 2-3 points I'll tell here. The details are already explained in the non-verbal communication video. You can just go around if you have missed any. The posture, whenever you go for an interview and sit in the interview, sit erect. You should be very straight in sitting, without leaning on the desk, slouching on the chair, and don't be stiff and tense. Do not erect means do not being stiff. Okay, erect means just sit straight, your back to be straight, your shoulder should be fine, but your body should be comfortable, and you should not stiff yourself. Okay, so do not be tensed, because if you are tensed, you are losing your confidence. So be very free and calm. Think that you are going for an interview, but the nervousness you show will be far enough for the interviewer to make you out of the job. So always make an eye contact when you speak, but avoid continuous staring. This is an important point what you have to keep in mind. Eye contact and staring is very different. While you answer, keep an eye contact with the interviewer. If it is a face-to-face and one interviewer is sitting, just keep an eye contact with him or her, whoever is taking an interview. But it doesn't mean that you go and staring him or her. It is just maintaining the eye contact. That's it. So don't use too many hand movements and frequent change of facial expressions, not in relation to the words you have expressed. So, and even do not change your facial expressions, and also your hand movements should not be much. You can just use some of the hand movements, but not to maximum. Avoid doing that. Then your face expressions should also not be changing frequently. It should be very stable, very less expressive on your gesture part. So these are the things what you are going to do. Then what about the dress? How you should dress formally and well groomed. You will never get a second chance to make a good impression. So your dressing very formally is very nice, very good. If you are going to an interview and if you are wearing your jeans and t-shirts, say if you are wearing a Bermuda, if you are wearing a 3/4, these are all the not allowed things. So what type of dress you have to wear, I am making another video. I'll be sharing that too on the platform, so you can have a look that what type of dresses a male or a female, whoever be, have to wear, how you have to groom yourself. So you should be well groomed. This is what I can say. In the next video I'll be leaving what do I mean about formally and well groomed. So what do I mean about I saying well-groomed, okay? So in that video, you can just have a check. You will never get a second chance to make a good impression. So remember, you will never get a chance, again, second chance to make a good impression. So please make a good impression by being well-groomed. Wear something that make you comfortable. That is very important. Wearing tight jeans or tight pants or salwar kameez, whatever you are wearing, and tight one, that is never comfortable to you, and that makes you will be focusing more on your dress, less on in the interview. So that is one thing. Be very comfortable, feel comfortable, wear comfortable things. Use simple accessories like simple jewelry, watches, ties. Yes, accessories, we see people wearing rings, length of things. So please avoid, wear very, very simple things. Simple jewelry, whatever, if you like, just one small single chain in your neck maybe, or wearing a watch, that's it. And wearing, if a boy or a girl, you can wear also a tie, so it's more than enough. Scents and perfumes and aftershave lotion should be avoided. You should avoid these things, scents, perfumes, which makes the interviewer discomfort. If you are wearing very high smelling perfumes, and if the interviewer gets disturbed by your perfumes or your scents, then he becomes uncomfortable regarding this. So please be aware of it. Expected qualities of the candidate. What type of qualities is expected in from a candidate? Now, what interviewer expects from you? It is, if it is English language without empty fluency, influence, normal delivery, fluency. You should have very normal delivery. I don't say you should have an American accent or UK accent. You should be having a very simple accent, understandable vocabulary. If you use these things, that's more than enough. You need not have very high level of English. Normal English, more than enough. Use very common words. Take your common library of vocabulary and use your, go to the interview. Okay, so and B, you should be very fluent in this regard. Pronunciation, you should be very clear that how I pronounce. Now, whatever I pronounce and tell you, you are understanding. And this is should be the this is the thing what you should do. The pronunciation should be very clear, and what you are saying should be understood by the interviewer. So pronouncing the sentences is also very important. Speak little, more loudly. You should speak very little, not much, but it should be in a high pitch. That is, you should speak a bit loud, that he should be audible. I don't say you need to shout, but speak some loud so that the interviewer could speak, or lower your voice to draw attention of the experts if there is an important point or opinion. And whenever you are giving an important point or opinion, you can change your tone and pitch and make the person to listen you carefully at that time, the point or opinion you are giving. So that makes your speak or your delivery more attractive. So that is what you should have, the such qualities which are expected from the candidate. What type of qualities rejected by the committees? So vague and irrelevant answers, whatever the questions are asked, and if you do not know, you will be giving some irrelevant answers which are not at all related to the question. So such irrelevant answers are really rejected. So please keep in mind, you need not do that. Very fidgety, little eye contact. If you are doing very little eye contact, that's also not accepted. You need not be nervous. Your mannerism is very important. Yes, mannerism, which you have to keep in mind. Mannerism, like if you are playing with your hair in your interview, say if you are putting your hands in your pocket, say if you're biting your nails, say if you're rubbing your hands, these are mannerisms. So you need not, if you're doing such mannerism, then you are surely being rejected by the committee. So please keep in mind the mannerisms. Lack of sincerity. If you're not sincere towards your speak, then 100% you are rejected. Utter superficial remarks to impress the interviewer. So some of the, like giving maybe about your quoting some project work regarding what you have done or anything as such. So they are very much important for you to get such a. Then do's and don'ts. So these things we are going to discuss, the do's, the don'ts in the interview. And tomorrow we will take up which type of questions will be asked and what are the answers you need to give. So do's, do take a practice run to the location where you are having the interview. You need to take a practice regarding it. So whenever you go for an interview, just a practice run to the location where the interview will be hanging. If presented with a job application, if you are given any application, please fill it very neatly, very and completely and accurately about your information. Do not continuously rough it out or strike anything to maximum extent. Fill it out very neatly, and it should be complete. Whatever the information you are asked, give it complete information, and it should be very accurate information. Do not give any false information in the form. And you have to keep in mind that you should keep extra resumes with you. If an interviewer asks you in the interview, please give your resume. So you need to be ready with your resume. So give an extra, keep a extra resumes for the interview. Then greet the interviewer and do shake hands firmly whenever you go there. Please greet the interviewer. That is important thing. You need to greet the interviewer, and you also you should shake hands very firmly. Keep in mind. So do greet interview and do shake hands firmly. Do wait until you are offered a chair before sitting. If you when you enter into the interview room, and if they do not offer you to sit, please till then do not sit. Be in the standing position. If they ask you to sit, till they offer you a chair, please do not sit. That is an etiquette you should follow in an interview room. Do make good eye contact with the interviewers. Again and again I am saying the same thing. To make eye contacts, very important. Not staring, I say eye contact is very important. Your enthusiasm in the position and the company. So you should show your enthusiasm, how enthusiastic you are to work in the company, how interested you are to work in that company and that position, whatever they are giving you. So do make sure that your good points come across to interviewer in a factual, sincere manner, and the interviewer should understand what exactly the things are being told. Do stress your achievements. So your achievements should be stressed. They should be told about your achievements, whatever you have achieved, if asked. And you need to give them all the details and list of achievements, whatever you achieved. So that gives them a plus point about why you will be selected, or what is the things they have to consider before selecting. Now don'ts, what you should not do. Do avoid controversial topics. Whenever asked to speak about any topic you are given to, please do not take any topic which is controversial and which creates controversies and makes your chance of getting selected very less. Don't ever lie. Answer questions truthfully, frankly, and succinctly. You need not answer a lie answer. You can just straight away tell. If you do not know, say, I don't know, sir. Don't say anything negative about former colleagues, supervisors, or employers. If asked, why you are leaving the previous job, if you are an experienced person, if you have worked somewhere else, why you are leaving there, why you are coming to us, so then give sincere answers, but do not say, give any negative remark about your colleagues with whom you have worked before, or your supervisors, or your employers. With whom you have worked, which shows that tomorrow if you leave this company and go for other company, again the same thing you may do. So at that time employer considers very less persons, people who do give negative remarks about their previous employers. So please keep in mind. Don't answer questions with a simple yes or no. Do not answer the questions if asked. Please do not answer anything, only yes or no. Give some one sentence answer or two sentence answer which makes you more probable for the selection. Explain whenever possible. Describe those things about yourself that showcase your talent, skills, and determination. Give some examples regarding your skills. If you are explaining about anything about your skills, then give examples about your skills. Showcase your talents, whatever you have. Determination. Don't inquire about salary. This is an important thing. Do not inquire about salary, vacations, bonuses, retirement, or any other benefits until you have been received an offer. Till you get selected and if you receive an offer, please do not speak anything about the salary and vacations if asked. Just say yes as the company rules. So don't bring up or discuss personal issues or family problems. That's all another thing you need to keep in mind, that do not take up any personal issues or family problems to be discussed in the interview room. Don't say your past history, hence it is available in the CV itself. And your past history about your qualification, about your any other history about your experience and all, they will already be present in the CV. So that's not to be discussed and more to be showcased, which is already there. So after the interview, just tell them one word, thank them for calling you for the interview through a letter or through a phone call or whatever means they have called you for. Indicate that you look forward to hear them, and you will indicate that. You just say Thank you, sir, for calling me for this such a wonderful interview in this company and this position. I'll be looking forward to hear from you, sir. So this is what you have to quote whenever after the interview you leave from the interview room. So these are the things what you have to keep in mind. So in the next class, we are going to discuss about the interview questions. What type of questions will be asked? We'll quote some of the questions, types of questions, and answers what you have to give in the next video. So I'll be discussing all those things in the next video. I'm very much thankful to all you guys that you have been patiently listening to my videos since